Good morning everyone and welcome to Economic Interpretation. Today we are going to discuss 23rd June 2021 daily current affairs. The PDF of this lecture given in our description below. You can easily just join our Telegram channel and download the PDF link of this lecture. So let's start with our current affairs discussion with our first question of 23rd June 2021. Our first question, Government of India will establish how many Divangata Khel Kendra in country. Now, Divangata Khel Kendra means the playing field or playing society for those are physically or mentally disabled. Those are known as the Divanga. Now, so recently Government of India will establish 5 new Divangata Khel Kendra in this country. And this announce was made by Union Ministry for Social Justice and Empowerment, Tarachand Gehlot. So Tarachand Gehlot, the Union Ministry for Social Justice and Empowerment, on June 20, 2021, announced for these 5 new Divangata Khel Kendra. And those Khel Kendra setting up in different parts of our country, and out of which Ahmedabad may be one of the city in which this type of facility available. Now go to our next question. Which Indian American chemist has been awarded with European Innovator Award 2021? So it European Innovator Award 2021. So the answer is Sumita Mitra. So Sumita Mitra won this prize for March Nanotechnology with Dental Science. And European Innovator Award is one of the most prestigious award for scientists or those who are researching on different fields of science. And in his history, Mitra was the first to successfully integrate nanotechnology into the dental material to produce strong and more aesthetically pleasing fillings or more normal fillings in teeth, which are now used by dentists around the world. Now go to our next question. Recently, Indian Navy has participated in UNAVFOR 2021 exercise in which Gulf? So recently, Indian Navy and European Union Navy jointly organized a naval exercise in Gulf of Aden. So the correct answer is Gulf of Aden, and on 18 to 19 June 2021, this naval exercise between European Union and India conducted. A total of 5 warships from 4 navies were participating in this 2 days exercise. So it's a 2 days exercise, naval exercise. Now go to our next question. Which country's PM Stephen Loven lost confidence voting? So this is mistake. So the question is, which country's PM Stephen Loven lost confidence voting? The answer is Sweden. Sweden PM named Stephen Loven in history first time lost the confidence vote. Now this is for the opponent not cooperation with Stephen Loven for a special bill, rent control. So Stephen Loven recently announced a bill, rent control, and the opponent are highly against this bill, and that's why they are not supporting PM Stephen Loven. And PM has 2 options in his hand. He may resign within a week, or he can call for a snap election. Now go to our next question. Recently, former RBI Governor Raghunath Rajan has been appointed in which state's Economic Council? So RBI Governor Raghunath Rajan recently appointed in Tamil Nadu as a in Economic Council. Not only Raghunath Rajan, also Esther Dablo and member of this committee. So Raghunath Rajan and Esther Dablo included in Tamil Nadu's Economic Council, and those 2 person appointed by Governor of Tamil Nadu Banwarilal Purohit. And besides being Raghunath Rajan and Esther Dablo, there are also some members like Governor Bansali Purohit also included. the former chief economist advisor to the central government, Dr. Arvind Subramaniam, from the field of development economics, and Jean Drej, and former union finance secretary, Dr. S. Narayan, and CM of Tamil Nadu, M.K. Stalin. Our next question, which ministry has launched Jaan Hai Toh Jahan Hai, this awareness campaign? So recently, Ministry of Minority Affairs launched the program named Jaan Hai Toh Jahan Hai, and the main aim of this program to reduce all rumors related to COVID-19 and COVID-19 vaccination. The Ministry of Minority Affairs launched the awareness campaign Jaan Hai Toh Jahan Hai in rural and remote areas. It's especially for rural and remote areas to dispel rumors against the ongoing COVID vaccination drive in this country. And this campaign is also reduce the crass and crab rumors from society. And this campaign launched by Ministry of Minority Affairs and various socio educational organization like NGOs and women self help groups, SGHS. Now go to our next question. According to the World Investment Report, India received how much FDI in 2020? Now recently this report published, and according to the report, 64 billion USD invested in India in terms of FDI, full form of FDI, foreign direct investment. And this report is published by UNCAD, which full from United Nations Conference on Trade and Development. And every year UNCAD publish this report. And India in the fifth largest recipient of foreign direct investment inflow in the world in 2020. So India in number fifth position in terms of FDI, and in first position USA, and in second position China. And in 2019, India's foreign direct investment 51 billion USD, and 2020 it became 64 billion USD. So it's approx 27% increase in FDI, which is good for Indian economy. Now go to our next question. Free COVID vaccination policy of central government for all adults has started from which state? So recently, central government announced vaccination for 18 plus, and it started from 21st June. So it's correct answer 21st June. And Prime Minister Narendra Modi announced this in television in his address to the nation program. And center would procure 75% of the vaccine and give them to states to free distribution to all citizens about the age of 18. So mainly central is providing this vaccine free of cost for the age of above the age of 18 people. Now go to our next question. According to the which IIT, aloe vera may be useful in making memory chip? So recently IIT Indore found that there are some ingredients in aloe vera which is helpful to making memory chip. According to an IIT Indore official said that they have found aloe vera to contain an electronic memory effect chemical. So in aloe vera, electronic memory effect chemical present, which is helped to create a memory chip. And he also said that the study was carried out by the material and device. So this study carried out by material and device laboratory of this institution and in physics department. Now the PhD student Tonusri Ghosh, who actually research on this field, carried out the study, and along with Suchitra Kandapal and Chanchal Rani and Manushri Tanwar and Divesh Kumar Pathak and Anjali Chaudhary, those are who are researching together in this field. Now go to our next question. Which UTs, Union Territory, all railway station have been connected to railway Wi-Fi network? So recently, Jammu and Kashmir UT, all railway station have been connected to railway Wi-Fi network. That's mean in Jammu and Kashmir, every railway station Now we can use Wi-Fi in free of cost, and this was announced by Piyush Goyal on International Wi-Fi Day. And international, and from here one most important question: International Wi-Fi Day we celebrate on 20th June every year, and main aim of this day is to provide internet in whole world, in more and more rural and separated parts of our world. And Piyush Goyal announced Srinagar and 40 stations of the Kashmir Valley have become a part of the one of the largest integrated public Wi-Fi network in the world, and passengers all 15 stations in the Kashmir Valley will be able to access this Wi-Fi network of this Indian Railways. Now go to our next question. Which government has launched course in yoga science? So recently Delhi government launched a course related to yoga science, and this announce was made in International Yoga Day by Delhi government Kejriwal Sarkar, and we celebrate 21st June as International Yoga Day. So Arvind Kejriwal said his government was starting yoga and meditation training center in the national capital Delhi, and it's a free instructor for those who want to learn yoga. So anyone who is want to learn yoga, he can learn it from free of cost from home and forming a group. He also launched 1 year diploma course, so also a 1 year diploma course in meditation and yoga science launch in this program. Now go to our next question. Centers transgender ID portal is now available in how many languages? So there is a transgender ID portal launch in 25th November 2020. In first, it's just on English language. The website transgender, this is the web address of this website. And recently, central transgender ID portal available in 10 languages. The languages are Bengali, Gujarati, Kannada, Malayalam, Maratha, Odia, Punjabi, Tamil, Telugu, Hindi, and apart from English. English is available from first, and the main motto of this website is to provide a certificate of that identity from the government. The certificate is given by government, and a new act passed 2019. And according to this act, the Transgender Person Protection of Right Act 2019 guarantees a trans person to self preserve gender identity and a certificate of this identity from the government. Now go to our next question. Which bank has become top performer among public sector bank in terms of MSME and retail loan growth in 2020-21 financial year? So the answer is Bank of Maharashtra. Bank of Maharashtra's performance is based in terms of MSME and retail loan growth in 2021. And MSME stands from Ministry of Micro, Small and Medium Enterprise, and headquarter of this Bank of Maharashtra in located in Pune, and its CEO A.S. Rajiv. He joined 2nd December 2018, and it founded 18th September 1935. So it's a kind of old bank. And in 2020 year financial year, Bank of Maharashtra MSME increase achievement for this bank. So Bank of Maharashtra with nearly 25.61% growth in ahead of this country, which is more than in State Bank of India recorded 16.47%. Now go to our next question. AIM Yoga app launched by which country? So recently on International Yoga Day, India launched AIM Yoga app. And the app has been developed in collaboration between WHO, World Health Organization, and Ministry of Ayurveda, Yoga, and Naturopathy, Unani, Siddha, and Homeopathy, or it's under the Ministry of Ayush. So, collaboration between WHO and Ministry of Ayush and Government of India, in India launched a app called My Yoga with help of Narendra Modi government. And the AIM Yoga app is available in Hindi, English, and French language, but it will be made available in the other UN language, United Nations, under United Nations, how many language available in all these language. This app may be available in future, and this may be in upcoming month. And through this initiative, PM Modi government aim to achieve one world, one health motto. So the main motto to launch this app is to achieve one world, one health. Now go to our next question. Which day we celebrate as the World Humanities Days? So June 21 we celebrate as World Humanities Days. And the main motto to celebrate these days is to awareness people about humanism more and more. And the day has been organized by the IHEU, which full from International Humanist and Ethical Union. And this day is start celebrating since 1980. And International Humanities and Ethical Union President Andrew Copson. So IHEU President Andrew Copson, and it's founded 1952. Its headquarters located in London, United Kingdom. Now go to our next question. Which day we celebrated as the World Hydrograph Day? So which day we celebrate as the World Hydrograph Day? The answer is June 22. And the main aim to celebrate this day is to acknowledge hydrograph and its importance to the human beings. And hydrograph is a geographical concept, and which is actually measure and characterization of the physical feature of ocean. How many ocean and what is the size of this ocean, seas, coastal region, lakes, rivers, and several geographical concepts. And the day is celebrated to make public aware of hydrograph and essential role that play in everyone's life. So how hydrograph measurement or hydrograph study help in our daily life, this is the main motto to celebrate these days. And today's theme and this year's theme, 100 year of international cooperation in hydrograph. So this year theme is this, and it's important for exam perspective. And this day was also celebrated to protest marine environment and 6F in international navigation around the world. And this day was celebrated by United Nations General Assembly, and the first resolution was accepted on June 21, 2005. So from 2005 this day is start to celebrate, and its headquarter located in Monte Carlo, Monaco, and its Secretary General Dr. Mathis Jones. And International Hydrography Organization found in 21st June 1921. Now go to our next question. Who named Ambassador of Forest Frontline Heroes at WWF India? The correct answer is Upasana Kamineni. So Upasana Kamineni named as an ambassador of the Forest Frontline Heroes at WWF India. And the full form of WWF is Worldwide Fund for Nature India, and was found with the express objective of ensuring the conservation of the country's wildlife and natural habits. So how our country's environment and natural habit change, it's observed by WWF. WWF headquarters located in New Delhi and founded in 1969. And the aim of this, appreciate this effort of frontline workers in hospital in the wildlife protection space. And WWF India has introduced Upasana Kamineni, director of Apollo Hospitals, as an ambassador of the Forest Frontline Heroines. And that's for today. If you like our video, you like, share, and subscribe to our channel, and download the PDF of this video from Telegram channel. By just joining our Telegram channel, you can download this video. Thank you.